everybody, and welcome back to StarMade. I'm Dugamus, and we're playing on the Star Squadron server. Today, we're going to finish up our elevator tutorial. Pretty up the floor, and add some neat features that I want for the elevator. So, let's get to it. First, we're going to go into build mode. My spaceship. That's the elevator car. So we're going this way. Okay, if you remember, we left off like this. Now, we could just fill in the holes and call it done. The elevator does indeed work. But I'd like to add some neat new features. What's the best way to go about this? Personal cargo is out of range. I was at another station earlier, so I do not have my central cargo set as my personal cargo. Okay. So, now I've got the stuff. Let's do something like this. Activation module. And a button. Turn this into a pulse. Okay. So, this is an area trigger. And you want this. Now, what would be cool, in my opinion, is something like that. That means when you walk into the center of this elevator, use it. When you walk into the center of this elevator, you set off this area trigger. Now, we can make it bigger, so it covers as much of the I don't know why those weren't selected. So it covers as much of the elevator car as possible. And if we go with this and connect it to these AND blocks, that means the car will not move unless you are standing on it when you push the buttons. Now, that's great and all, but that means you have to actually go on the elevator car, hit the button, and then it'll go down. But if you're already in this area, you won't be able to select these buttons very well unless you stand right at the very corner, and that's not what we want. So what we're going to do is we're going to take out these buttons. And we're going to replace them. Whoops. Deselect what we're working. We're going to replace them with activators. Now, these things should stay active. But then something like this can happen. You have two options selected. So we're going to fix that. We're going to go over here where we have some space. And we're going to put... What is the best way to do this? I'm going to put a button. We're going to deselect everything we're working with. We're going to put two buttons here. And okay. So we want these to trigger their individual aims, right? And then we want the ands. Let's go ahead from this side, right? Left is down. Right is up. Let's make sure these are linked both ways so that we can use these buttons to control whether these are lit. So that one's linked to that one. That one's not linked to that one. Okay, so now if you hit down here, it lights up that one. Whereas if it weren't linked... This one would light... Oh, sorry, I got that backwards. If it were linked just to that one, it'll light it. But then turning this one off will not turn off this one. So we definitely want them both. We want them linked so that they act like they're one button. Okay, so... Right is up. So we want to link that one. To that. And that one to that. So that... If you hit this button, and this button's on, this will light up. Well, what do we want to do when that lights up? We want this one to trigger that one, and that one, trigger that one, so that, okay, the up button is turned on. If we hit this button while the up button is turned on, it'll turn the up button off. We hit it while it's off, nothing. Okay. But we also want these to trigger each other's turn off. So that one links to that one. And that one links to that one. So that if we... Here, let's deselect everything. If we hit up, and then we hit down, and then the server lags, so I can't do the demonstration. Catch up with me, server. Okay, so the bottom one's lit. We hit the top one, the bottom one unlights. Vice versa. Right. Okay, so now we want to go down here. Let's get out of our build block and go to the elevator. Into the elevator. Dee-lee-lee. And I don't think I'm in gravity. There, now I'm in gravity. So that's off. Walking here triggers the activate. Yay. But if you push down and then walk here, the elevator goes down automatically. Yay. Let's go back up. Well, we do have a lovely problem. Did you just see what happened? If I go up, this isn't unselected, so the elevator car tries to go back down right away. So that means we want this momentary trigger trigger the reset. So it's down. I walk in. It should have triggered the reset. And if I go back up, you're no longer lit. Elevator stays put. You can get off the elevator. Now, there are some situations that still don't work. Like, I'm standing in the middle of the elevator. I hit this button. Or I can't hit this button. So that's one of the problems. But if I come here and hit this button right on the edge, it doesn't do anything. I have to get off of the car, go step back on the car, and nothing happened because I hit up. Let's do a better example where I hit down. I have to get off the car, go back in the car, and it goes down. So, that's that. But now, if you want to clean this up a bit, because we have these lovely buttons here no longer immediately triggering the elevator to move because you're not stepping on it, we can do something neat like this. Select this. I think that's the one that the bulk this trigger actually triggers. Yeah. So that's the call mechanism. Now if we go back in our build block temporarily. Wow, we're out in space. If we go back into our build block temporarily, go down to the floor below, and we call the car down. Button. Okay, so the car is down. Now we're going to get out of the build block. Make sure we're still in gravity. Deselect everything. Now, if I say, I want to go down, the elevator car is instantly called to my floor. And then I step on it, and I go down. So, that means we can go back in this build block, go to this button, no longer needed. This button's no longer needed, and this button's no longer needed. Because those normally would have been how you called the elevator. But now that we have this lovely system in place, you don't need them. So now we can close up the floor. We can close up the floor. Eventually. Delete the build block. And look. Our room is ready to be decorated. We could put in some couches over here, maybe a little table, whatever you want people to have while they would be waiting for an elevator, theoretically. I mean, this elevator only has 3 floors, so you're not going to be waiting forever. It moves rather quickly. But, you know, for like role playing and stuff, you have like a couch and a coffee table, maybe some lamps, some plants and stuff. You know, your basic decorations. And we would automate this door so that it's not something you have to press. Now I can go down wherever I want. And of course, I'm going to finish up these floors, and if we revisit the elevators at any point, you know, maybe if they fix the wireless in this decade, I'll show you how to do that properly without all this lovely wiring voodoo I've had to put in. And, that is that. Thank you for watching my slightly shorter tutorial this week. And thanks for watching StarMade. I'm Dugamus. This has been the Star Squadron server.